Welcome to Badminton Tips and Tricks. Today, we're going to help you differentiate the differences between a fake Yonex racket and a genuine Yonex racket. And we will show you the differences between these two. This is Ian from Northwest Badminton and ProRacket.net. Let's go. First thing we notice from a genuine racket and a fake racket will be the pricing. The fake racket will be a lot cheaper than the genuine racket for sure. As the Chinese saying goes, 一分钱一分货, you get what you pay for. So when you're paying a lot less than other general people, that means something's going on right there. So a lot of fake rackets are actually SP models, that is just shown by the big data. But SP and CH model also have genuine rackets, but of course the price will be a lot higher. Let's take Asterox 100ZZ for example. I have one that's from a customer and I have one that's from our store. The first thing that I want to show you guys is the hologram stickers on Yonex products. Not just rackets, they have hologram stickers on every single product, including socks, insoles, strings, etc. So when you buy a Yonex racket or a Yonex product without the hologram sticker, 99% it's a fake. The hologram sticker is not very easy to peel off, so it should and will be able to stay on the product at all times. Now, when the store gets a Yonex racket from customers that has a hologram sticker on and you would like to verify it, usually we use this thing. Yonex sent us this thing. I think most of the authorized dealers will have this as well. So this is a hologram sticker in examination. One part is when you slide through the hologram sticker, it's invisible. And when you slide to the other side, the sticker will become visible. And that's one way for us to know whether this product is genuine or not. Now, as for consumers, when you're at home, you don't have this kind of things. How can you spot the differences? First is we look at the cap. So the bottom of the racket has the Yonex cap. For the genuine one, usually the color is a lot darker. And the YY logo, the Yonex logo, looks a lot clearer and sharper. As for the fake one, you can spot easily. It's very blurry and the green color is just not right. So that's that. There are a lot of different fakes out there. There are good fakes, there are bad fakes. Well, for me, they're all fakes. So if I were you buying a racket, I would definitely consider buying a genuine racket. Why do we want to buy a genuine racket rather than a fake racket? Well, because you like the game of badminton, might as well invest something into the game that will let you enjoy a lot more. If money is one of your concerns, you can always buy an intermediate model from Yonex, because even though it's an intermediate model and it's from a genuine Yonex store, it will definitely perform a lot better than a fake high-end Yonex racket. So 100ZZ in front of me, if we take even closer into details, you can see that when we feel the paint on the side, the fake one feels very rough because a lot of Yonex paint is not just painted up there. They have multiple layers and stickers before they put the final painting on. So usually for the real Yonex, it feels a lot smoother. Now for 100ZZ, it's a pretty hard fake to do because 100ZZ from Yonex comes with ultra slim solid shaft. So it's very, very slim. As for the fake, well, right here, it's super thick. I mean, yes, you can still play with it, but why? Now, last I want to show you is the biggest, and I think it's the most important part between the genuine and the fake. So it's the shaft and the T-joint. And of course, with a good shaft and a good T-joint, the racket should not bend easily. But let's take a look at the fake one. So when I hold the grip and when I try to twist the head, you can see the head is easily twisted. It's because the carbon and the materials is just crap. It has no intention of holding my power back, so it just let me push and bend the racket head, which is really bad. Now for, of course, the genuine racket, when I try to bend it, it's actually very hard to bend because it has a really nice T-joint, of course, high quality carbon graphite mixture. Now, you might say because Asterox 100ZZ is the high-end racket, it comes with a better material. Well, of course, but if we take a look at the intermediate model, which is Astrox 7, which is priced around $100, take a look at the T-joint and the quality. If I try to bend it, it's still very hard to bend because it's a genuine racket. So that's the biggest difference between a fake and a genuine racket. Next time when you go shop around, when you take a look at rackets, if you see a major price differences, you better watch out because you might be buying a fake. This is Ian from North Face Badminton and ProRacket.net. Hope you like the content, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.